everyone, and welcome to another episode of the Jazz Transcription Clinic Podcast Live. Today I'm quite excited because I have a few news to share with you, and today I also will be transcribing the Michael Brecker tenor saxophone solo on The Cost of Living, which follows the Charlie Hayden solo which we transcribed on the last live episode. So the big news is that doing my research, I bumped into this web platform called Soundslice, which is specifically designed to transcribe music. And it's done, in my opinion, very well, and it's very helpful. So I've been playing with it for a bit, and I would like to share you, you know, its functions and to show you how it works and what we can do with it. And I will do it while transcribing the Michael Brecker solo. So let me just jump into the platform, which is this one. And as I said, it's called Soundslice and is reachable at soundslice.com. It's a platform that offers some plans, so you can also use a free plan. I started with a free plan and then I decided to switch to Plus, because with Plus you have more functions available. You can print it out, you can export into a music XML file, which can be open into any notation software like Sibelius or Finale. So it will be very good to put it on a notation software to give, you know, a better look maybe. But it's a very complete platform. So let me show the idea behind this platform. So over here you have the basically the desktop page of your own account, and I have already created some slices. So slices are the projects, the transcriptions that you are working on. They are called slices. You can organize into folders. So I have created a folder called Transcriptions for Live Podcast. So I simply click and I can click on New Slice. So, and here are some options. You can start already with a notation file if you already have a transcription on a notation file. You can start, and I think this function is more if you want to practice the music that you have, like for example on Sibelius, because with this platform you can practice as well. I will probably show you some of these functions, but today I want to choose this one. Start with a recording. Choose a YouTube video or upload a video. You can upload your own video if you have a video file. You can upload your MP3 if you have just a MP3, like an audio file. But you can also embed like a YouTube video or a Vimeo. So the most popular videos. So if I click on YouTube video or video URL, you can simply grab the link of the video you're interested in and paste and copy here. So this is the link to the Michael Brecker, The Cost of Living video on YouTube. And here it is. Here is the track. Now it will take a few seconds. And now at the top here, you can see the track. And if I click on play, it will start playing. And here you can see the music, the waveform, basically. So the great thing about Soundslice is that you can add the notation. So you can transcribe and immediately write down the notes. So I want to click on Add Notation in Editor, and there are some information that are required. What instrument are we going to transcribe? So I click on Other, and I put like saxophone, tenor sax, and written in, I would like to have it written transposed for tenor sax. So here you go, in this menu you have all the transpositions. If you play, for example, English horn, you will pick this one, but this is for tenor sax. No tabs, because we don't need them on the saxophone. And visualizations is basically if you want to have like a keyboard at the bottom and you can see the notes on the keyboard, but we don't need that. So I think we are all set to go. We click on OK. And here we have our empty stave. So we can, of course, set a key. And in our case, it will be D minor for tenor. So we click on F major / D minor. And we say set key signatures. I would like to have the video probably a little bit smaller. All right, so now you can start writing the music and transcribing. So what are the main functions of this? The main functions are, of course, that here at the bottom, you have the speed control, which is very handful because you can slow down. Let me find, for example, a random, and I slow it down. And it's pretty good, even 50%, you can hear that the audio start to deteriorate, but it's still understandable. You can still grab a lot. At least the pitch and the rhythm. So let me go back to 100%. Here you can create loops. So you simply click and drag, and then you click loop, and you can loop a section, which will be handy, you know, if you want to back to some bars more than one time. And here on the left, you have this panel that is basically where you are going to input all the notes. The bars, the expressions, so accents and embellishments, repeat sign, coda. This is for tabs. Dynamics, this is for strings and harp or breath mark, you know, for us. You can include any text everywhere you want, even chords. And also some engraving functions. So it's pretty complete and I will show you. So how you do a transcription? First of all, you need to create downbeat. It's called here out downbeat. Basically, you need to add the beat one of each bar. So let me go and search for, I guess this will be the end of Charlie Hayden. Yeah. Right. So first thing I need to do is to create the bars. And this is very easy. You can listen through the track. And every time you hear beat one, you press the letter T on your computer keyboard. So now we have all those bars set. Probably I had to start with a bar before, because that scale that he plays here, that's like a pickup on bar one. So we want to make another bar around here. 2, 3. Right. So now we can, for example, if I click inside one bar and then I click loop, I can loop that bar. Thank you. Okay, I can slow it down. Okay, what I can hear is that he doesn't start to play until more or less the end of the fourth beat, right? One, two, three, four, and. Right? Two, three, four, and. So we are going to insert 3 beats rest or 3.5 beat rest. And to do that, so it starts with a crotchet rest. And if you want to it to become a rest, you have to press the note R. And now it's definitely a rest. Now we need to transform, probably I would like to transform it into a dotted minim, so 3 beats rest. And we have 2 ways to do it. One is to click on the minim and it has changed into a minim, and then you click to a dotted note. Another way that, if you make something wrong, if you do something wrong and you want to go back, is any other software. Like any other software, you press Command Z on a Mac or Control Z on a PC. The other way you can change the duration of the note is to use your computer keyboard, and with a plus sign, you will halve basically the duration, you see. And with the sign minus or the dash, you will double the value. So I want to go to a minim, and then I press dot on my keyboard, and there you go, I have a dot and minim. And now to go to the next note or the next beat, I simply click on my computer keyboard, I click arrow right, the right arrow, and I move forward. And now it has, you know, memorized the last value that you inserted. We need to make this a rest, so I play R first, and then I halve the value till I reach a quaver. There you go. And now I move into the next beat, and it takes a quaver. Did you notice that here at the top you can see what we have typed here? And this is great because you can be very, very accurate. You can understand where the music starts and where to put it by looking at where the music is placed on top here. We will go more in detail. Maybe we can do it a little bit bigger. Now, we still need to do the hard work of transcribing, right? So the rhythm and the pitch still needs to be transcribed by us. And here you have 2 options. Either you use your instrument to get the notes, da, da, da. These are C, D, E. You hear that? And this is basically a C major scale. Right, what I hear is a C major scale with B natural. Another way you can do it is to type a note here. So you select the place on the bar where you want to insert notes, and you decide on the value of those notes. So if we need to fit all those notes in one quaver, do da di da do da di da, those are 8 notes. So 8 notes, it will be, if it is semi-quavers, is 2 semi-demi-quavers, is 4 semi-demi-demi-quavers, will be 8. So we need to have 1, 2, 3 times this one. So it will be 64th notes, right? And we start typing the notes using the keyboard. So C. So now we need to insert all the other notes in the scale. We click right with the arrow and we type D. Right E. Right F. Right G. Right A. Right B. But we want this to be B natural. So we can click here on the natural, or we can click on Command H if you want to use the keyboard. And then C. And there you go. We have our 8 notes. And I think it's quite accurate, right? What you can do, like, and go to the 4th note where I want the this bit to be disjoint, and I click here and boom, voila, now it's a bit better and more readable. Now I need to add a bar, so I go to bars and add bar after selection. So there you go, and I can already add, you know, a few bars. Great, we have the first bar done. Let's go to the second bar. So again, I click inside the bar and I toggle cycle. So what I hear is ta-da-da, grace note. I would like to type a grace note as a 16 note, and the first note is da 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 da, so it's C, C sharp would be the grace note. Here it is, the first one, and if I go on the notes here, I can toggle the grace note, or I can press Z, which I will be doing on the C sharp. That makes sense. Okay, and how long was the high D? Da-da-da! I think it's something like 2 beats. Let's listen to it again. So I click on cycle. Yeah, like 2.5 beats probably. Da-da-da! Da-da-da! Yeah, 2.5 beats. So again, first the rhythm, that's a minim, and it's a note D. Now this is interesting because it's tied to a quaver. So I move on, select a quaver as D, and with the letter L on your keyboard, you put a tie with the previous note. Pretty cool, huh? So this would be probably a 16 note. And then there is a famous Breckerism. Zagado! And that would be probably semi-demi quavers. So this would be a quaver. Ta-da. Right. So now, of course, it doesn't follow exactly because we have only written 3 beats. So he's using the whole space of a bar for 3 beats. If I move this number 3 to here, then it will follow. But I don't mind. So I will... Okay, this is not too difficult. Do-de-o. So as I said, we press another quaver. And we put a tie with the note before. This would be a dotted quaver, right? And then da-di-do to land again on the G of the next bar. So we need to fit 2 notes into a 16 note, into a semi-quaver. So it will be 2 semi-demi quavers. And the notes are G and C, landing on a G. So remember from last time, when in doubt, put a hole. Now we can try to listen and try to see whether we have been accurate. Now, as I said, there is a Breckerism here. So How is it done on the tenor saxophone? You can find all those informations in line or online, but it has been studied a lot. You know, he was using the power of harmonics. So on the note D, while you're still pressing the note D, if you press the fingering for G, so both index middle finger and ring finger of the left hand down, while still pressing the A, you will produce basically a fake D, like a harmonic, which is like a fake sound of a D. And this is how he does it. So we need to mark that thing down because it's pretty characteristic. And then when we want to play it, we need to make clear that there is something going on there. And so we can open the expression panel, and maybe I would use this one to put a cross, a plus sign on top of the first D, so we know that there is something going on there. Right, I'm pretty happy with that. Let's go to bar three. Right, so it's da do da 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 do da da. So I'm pretty sure you know what it is. I select the first note and I half, so that is two beats, and then it will be tied to a semi quaver, which it will be G, and I press L. And this will be probably a dotted quaver. So I go to a quaver, D dotted, and tie it to the note before. And this will be a semi-quaver G sharp. G, and I can add the sharp either clicking on sharp here or Command J on the note keyboard. So let's listen. It's probably like a grace note. So let me put this as a quaver, not dotted, and we delete this. So to delete it, simply press delete twice, and this will be a grace note, the G sharp landing on A. Now you can also right, listen back from top. So I click here and press play. Make it visible. Okay, pre-bodo. This is, even this one is not too difficult. Remember how we do the grace note, even a quaver, grace note, it's G sharp, so G, Command J, and Z to make it grace note. Twee do do. This would be two semi quavers. Twee do do. And of course, if you're not sure about the pitch, you can sing back, you can check the notes. I think D do do, this is pretty it. F, and then a quaver of G, which is not sharp, so we need to naturalize. D do do, tied to what I think it's a crotchet. Da do. Let me listen. Okay, I can hear that he is playing like another crotchet or maybe even a quaver of D. So we tied with the note before, and then it will be all rest. So we click D, and then this will be a dotted minim, right? Click R, rest. There you go. And we can click here. This starts to be complex, but hey, we don't like simple things. Oh, one thing, if the music is too small, you can click here on settings in the bottom right corner, and you have a zoom level and you can increase. And I think I will use this one for the next bar. Okay, so this is basically, you know, a group of notes that we need to understand where they go. Ta-da! The two top notes, which should be D and F, those are, those are beat 3 and 4, right? Yeah. So we know that we need to fit those notes, and it's starting like after the first beat. So what are the notes? Here I think I would I would create a loop maybe here. Okay, sounds like a pentatonic, right? Starting on G, and this is, guys, when the theory and to know the sound of a mode of a scale is really handy. So I could pick the pentatonic. So if I get the first note, which should be G, so I know all the rest of the notes. Yeah, he goes up on the pentatonic. We know now that we have to fit that pentatonic into the second beat, basically, because the first beat is off, as you can hear. So we are here, first beat is off, so we make a crotchet rest and we go on. I think it starts on the end of the second beat, rest, and then maybe we have four notes. So again, we go here and we have, we said G. Okay, it picks the closest G to the last note that you have, so this is the closest G. It's very easy to drop an octave. You simply go command and arrow down. And then right, A, C, D. So I want to take these four notes and make it the half. There you go, 64. And then I select the last one, and it will be F, G, A, and C. And as we said, this will be two crotchets of D and F. Let's listen to it. Of course, when I tapped the bar in at the beginning, I might have been a little bit imprecise. And also, you know that in jazz, especially on a ballad, it's very hard to keep the metronome very stable. So there is a natural fluctuation. And this is when Soundslice is so powerful, because I can actually place those notes exactly where they happen. There is a little hesitation on this F, isn't it? But I don't want to become too complex with the writing, you remember from last times. So I would probably just put this, that I know that there is a little thingy there. And here, there is another Breckeries, which is beautiful. The F is so suffered as a note. The sound is almost corrupted, and he moves. It just slides onto the F and goes to softer, much softer dynamics. So these are all the things that, guys, we need to learn after the transcription. So, of course, if you want, and I always recommend this, you should memorize it first. Because when we memorize the solo, we can learn the sound, the actual sound of everything that we hear. And look at the first phrase, you know, it looks so complex, but if I have to play it, if I memorize it, right? Something like that. So it's really important that we get the correct sound. Now, on Soundslice, if I'm not wrong, I searched up for a glissando and I couldn't find it. So probably we can toggle this, or maybe select the F and toggle the scoop so that we know that this note is basically glissing to that note. And maybe, you know, if we want to be even more precise, we can do a diminuendo, not here, though, on this note, a diminuendo, so that we know that this note is much, much softer. And I know, guys, he arrives a little bit later. Right. So that's beat two. And this is not happening. We can put the scoop. Dory. And it's probably tied here to another F, and there is a quaver rest, and now, so it's the end of the four again, so this will be quaver, and here we need to insert those notes. Now, as we did before, let's grab. I can hear E natural and C sharp. But maybe knowing a bit Michael Brecker, I think a nice version would be to write all the notes. Right, so I write this, and it will be E, D, C, E, and we land on an A. Again. All right, D, and the last semi-quaver is a G, right? D, do, G. This is what he does here. Let's listen. Two, three, four. Yes. And there is a thing I really love here, which is, so how to write it? Remember, guys, make the half of the bar very clear. This is really important. I don't like writing a dotted minim here. I would rather do this. And now this will become, you know, the half of the bar, and it's visible, and I like it. And this will be a dotted quaver tied, And the last note is a semiquaver G, we said. Let's listen to it. Did you hear, guys, that here, at the very last moment of this note, he vibrates the note, shakes the notes a little bit. And that's so beautiful. He keeps that note like a blade till the end, and just at the very end, gives a little shake. And these are the things that we need to study. Again, everybody is able to play an A, but that A is very difficult. Right? So those are the little details that makes a solo a great solo, that makes the phrasing, that gives you personality when you play. And why not pointing it out by writing, for example, here at the top we'll write vibrato. And again, you have a lot of controls, font style. I like italics, font style. Oh yeah, I like this a little bit bigger, maybe. And there you go. We have written vibrato. Let's go to the next bar. So the first 8 notes are semiquavers. And what I hear, again, you know, my theory connected to the ear, which I used to call theory, T-H-E-A-R-Y, is the theory that you learn through your ears, tells me that this is the sound of the tritone substitution. So the harmony here is A7 for the saxophone, probably flat 9, because we are in a minor key. And here I can recognize the E flat major arpeggio. Over an A dominant. And that's the tritone, of course. And that's a characteristic sound of the tritone substitution. So we got the notes. C, D, do, do. So the first 3 notes are like C minor, but I think he's already thinking over either the altered scale or the diminished scale, or simply the tritone substitution. And we said they are semiquavers, and it starts on the note G, and then right, C, right, G, and then E flat. Now I can type E and then Command G makes it flat, and then B flat, but it's this B flat here. So as I said, Command arrow up, and then this is an E flat major pitch. D do D B G. So if you need to understand those notes, you can sing it. Let's leave the embellishment out for now, but so once you get the notes, you can add the embellishment back. And there is a mordant here. Now, I couldn't find the mordant here. I could only see the trill. But here is another great tool that you have on Soundslice. That here at the top, you see search. I simply typed in mordant. And here you go. You have it. Ornament, mordant. You click, and there you go. And then you click out here. Mm-hmm. ending on top C. Right? So, we can do in two ways. We can count how many notes we have. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. 10 notes. So it would be clearly two quintuplets. And we can click already on the tuplet. And you have a simple triplet, but this toggle on the simple triplet. Or if you want to do a new tuplet, you can toggle this one and it will be five notes in the space of four, right? Set tuplet. And there you go. You have the quintuplet and you can fill in the notes. This is B natural, remember? C, D, E. And then there is exactly the same thing. So I could probably use, so I can show you the copy and paste thing. Copy. And then I go to the next bit, paste. And I have just to change the note. Now, I can also drag the notes. This will be A. This will be B natural. B natural. And the last note is C. Right. Let's listen. I think I'm pretty happy. Let's listen once at full speed, maybe from top. Let's go from top. Here, so that it's clearly a D, but here is a bit flat. That's a bit flat. So again, we can use maybe here. I can put like an arrow, and it's a little bit hidden, so I can also, if I want, maybe put it in brackets. So I can understand. I love it. I love this one. Let's slow it down a little bit. Okay, so ba-di-da-do-da, that's another quintuplet, right? Yes, the landing note of that twirl is basically on the second beat. So this is a rest, and I make it a quintuplet. So five notes in space of four, that's right. And the notes are A, B, A, G sharp, is G sharp, A, pa-di-da-do-da. This is a little bit longer, so I would put probably a quaver, and then da-ya on the altissimo. So that would be A and B flat as grace notes, da-ya. And I like a scream, like a very suffered. So let me put those two. I toggle with Z and I move an octave higher and I make another one B flat. I toggle the Z and this is that scream is basically a minim of a altissimo A. You see that? We want this to be here. Might be too much. Yeah, pretty happy. Next. That's a G, right? But there is an F sharp as a grace note. And this will be a quaver grace note, F sharp. So F, command J, and Z. That's a crotchet G. And then there is a triplet, this time a simple triplet. This is the beginning of All of Me, right? So it will be a major triad descending from the tonic. Da, and the first note is F, so it's F major, F, C, A, and it's a quaver triplet. So I put F, and this time I can toggle the triplet by pressing the triplet button, and then C, and then A. Okay, da, do, do, that's tied to an A, da, this G, F, G, F, do, do, three, there is a grace note, G sharp, grace note, A, quaver, and then there is another grace note, F sharp, and this is a grace note, three, do, do, do. This is a semi-quaver, G, natural, F, natural, and that will be a D. We can probably add more bars, like to have more space. We go maybe from here. Right, so this is a minim, and then, guys, did you recognize this? It's basically the same stuff, right? The rhythm is a little bit different, but I could recognize that the notes are the same. So I would fit this time. That's basically, there is a quaver rest, crotchet rest, and then, so I would do this, guys. And the notes are the same as above, A, C, D, and then F, G, A, C, D. Oh, I almost forgot to say one very important thing. We need to save our slice. If you go out from this window or something happens and we didn't click save, we are doomed. We lose all the work. So we don't want that to happen. That's a crotchet tied into a quaver. And this will be a triplet. Tied into a that would be Babrio, Babrio. You heard that. So that's quaver rest. And then semi quaver, E flat. And then two semi quavers, D and D flat. And this is a C. Right, I'm happy. Let's move on. Cycle. Ooh. So I can hear that that is beat three. So I can probably select this beat. Okay, there is another Breckerism here. Let me write it down. From what I heard, it's a crotchet and it's tied to basically a quaver. So I go here, it's still a C tied, and then A, and this is D flat. Da, 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 da. That will be a semi quaver, just a semi quaver. Da, 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 da. Right, I now want to loop the whole bar. Because I miss another semi-demi quaver here. So here's another function. If you miss to insert a note, you need to add here a note and you make semi-demi quaver and you press L. Oh, now we talk. Da. Da, dee, da, da, da. And this is another Brecker like the one that we had before. B natural, D, do, 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 do. Right. So there is A flat, A flat, G, G flat, F, da, and G natural. Da. And this is five notes, so we can do 5/4. Yeah, da, da, da. I would probably divide here. I don't like what is written. Okay. Breckerism here. You remember what we did? Put a cross. And on the A, we simply press like the fingering for D without the G. That's how you do it. Right, and tida, another cross here. Ta-da-da. It's pretty cool. It creates like an effect, like if it's repeating those notes. So, oh, the last note, it's a low E. That's on B2. Ta-da-da-da-di-da-da-di-da-da-di. So we need to count all those notes. Da 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 di da do di da do da. 11. So it will be 11 tuplet then. and we can put semi demi quavers again, and the notes will be da, and we put 11 in the space of 8, right? Because it's one beat, so we write 11 equals to 8, and there you go. Ba, C, G, F, E, D, C, B natural, T, D, A, G, F, sorry, wrong note, F, wrong octave, and we land on E. Do, 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 do. So that will be a quaver, dotted quaver, E, and a semi quaver, G, C. I don't know how long is this. Let's go out from this. Oh, there is a crotchet, dum, dum, and it's tied to a quaver triplet, dum, and this is a triplet. Oh, wrong button. Da, di, dum, da, and let's put a hole when in doubt. Oh, I miss it. This is da, do, do, and this is C, and this is tied. Now, oh, because it's not tied. This is a minim, and then we have another big scale over the pentatonic. There is a quaver rest. We can copy probably this beat. Copy and paste here. We create a semi demi quaver and paste. Now we are missing bibbidi-do, right? Bibbidi-do, and I would put it maybe like that. D flat, and this is a quaver. Oh, I'm going too far. This is a quaver C, which will be tied into another C, and I need to move this. Right. Lilac. Da. Da, da, dee, da. De, crotchet tied into quaver. Da. It's a semi-quaver, dotted, and this is a semi-quaver, quaver, ba ba da ba, da do, da. Right, I'm happy. And of course, we can do a lot of adjustments there. bar. Let's loop the next bar. All right, and here, you know, we select a small portion. We can go a little bit slower. What I hear is a E flat dominant sound. Something like that. Yeah. Again, D flat, G F low C B flat tied to something, and that will be one beat, half a beat, so this must be a quaver. Right. Right, I'm happy there. Let me get the... Right. Is that the diminished scale? Yeah, not that one. B flat, and then a quaver rest, and then this will be the last beat, right? B flat, G, and E flat. E flat. What about now? It's 6/4. Do, 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 do. And I need to add another note, which would be F, and then I go back here. Sorry, guys. Ah, now I like it. Do, 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 do. So let's try. Let's try to put it right. G sharp, A, B natural. I can't remember what is it. Command H, C, D, E flat, E flat. Right. F, F sharp, and G sharp. So here at the top you can see that here is where right, I'm happy. Let's move on. I really want to finish the solo so that we can B natural, C, E flat, E natural, and E flat again. D flat, right? It's actually C flat. Da, 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 B flat. this has to be like that. And this, why is not tied to the next beat? That should be right. Okay. I need to go faster. And this is a quaver then. And I want to tie this. And I want to tie this. I mean, not tied, but join. And join this. Oh, right. I think I like it. This is a little bit. Alright, let's write it in a simple way. Tied and rest, and then we need to figure out whether I think this is right, but let's check. And it's basically on the last beat. It's right after the down beat. So 1, 2, 3. And then we need to write the notes. It's what I can hear is like and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 7 notes. D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, and G sharp. Probably there is. It's not a 7th doublet. There is A. Yeah, and now we can adjust the breath. Yeah, ba ba da, ba ba da. B flat, ba C. D flat, up, D flat, da da da, dwe. So there is a scoop on the same note, which is D flat, and we add the scoop immediately. Da, dwe, du. This is a B flat, right? Ta-da, one, da wa. So I would write quaver rest, right? Oh, this is easy. Finally, something easy. Thanks, Michael. That's tied into a crotchet, right? And then this, what I heard was quaver rest, ba ba ba, F G B flat. Let's have a listen. Okay, here I was a bit late because they play a rallentando here. There's a scoop here. Did we do, right? So that's a minim. P A flat. Move the A flat. Okay, it's not a minim, the A flat, but it's a crotchet, maybe dotted crotchet, and then there is a quaver rest. Right. And let's put it in. Put it in. Yeah, I would put again F sharp, and it's a grace note, and then grace note. Da da da, A flat, da da da, crotchet probably, ba ba da, A flat, da da da. It's a crotchet tied to a quaver. This is right. Right. I want to delete everything here. Okay, bah, that would be a G sharp. Blah, G sharp, grace note. Da. And this is, if you remember, we transcribed the head, so we already have it. We could even import as an XML file, but it's dum, da, da. And then there is a ba, A flat, right? And probably a rest. Okay, it takes a breath here, so maybe we can delete this. And there was the breath mark somewhere, I think it was here, right? And we can put, you know, even breath marks. How good is that? And then it goes on, you know, that's the head out. So we have finished. That's the whole solo. We can check at full speed from the beginning. how beautiful. You can make it a little bit smaller so that it stays inside the page, you know, and you can follow. And now you can practice it. To practice, you switch at the top here, practicing, and everything vanishes. You see on the side, now you have, you know, my face and the logo, but you can see the whole solo. And basically you can practice the whole thing. But you can also use this, and maybe you zoom in a little bit more. There you go. I just noticed that here there are two beats missing, so that would be a rest. Great. And then I think here it wasn't too accurate. Was it here? Of course, here we can write RAL, right? And write RAL on top. And then you can play along. Video, but I thought of doing that and showing you. Hopefully the next solo that I'm going to transcribe will be a little bit easier. But you know, when you transcribe such a great player like Michael Brecker, especially on a ballad, this is what you end up with. Because on the ballad the space is much wider. So thank you for watching, and see you next